So the next topic is inheritance. And the idea of inheritance is you take a class and you want to make a new class. You can think of it as extending it and adding a little bit of special sauce to a class. And it's a really a good pattern, much like functions, of not repeating yourself. If you have some functionality in like a base class or in like a core class, and then you're going to specialize it a little bit, it's just another form of how not to repeat yourself and how to structure your code. Now, a big problem that people have when they do object-oriented programming is they figure that if they're not doing inheritance, they're not cool. And I will say that's absolutely not true. If you go for 5 years and you never do inheritance, it's important to understand it, but don't feel bad. You could write objects, you could use objects, and never do inheritance. You're using inheritance when you're using library code because we use it a lot. When you the day that you start writing a sophisticated piece of library code for other people to use, you'll be like, oh, thank heaven for inheritance. But don't feel like the goal, I mean, one of the biggest mistakes people make in object orientation is just trying to like overuse inheritance. So understand it, but don't feel like you got to show off and use it just to use it. So we have a parent class and child class. The child class inherits everything from the parent class, except that which is overridden or added in the child class. Another word for this is subclasses. It's class and a subclass. I think of it also as extending. In some languages like Java, they use the word extend to say extend this thing. Okay, so here we go. So let's take a look at that code that we wrote before. And again, this is a silly, silly example so that I can fit them on a screen. You know, I don't want to... But remember the class hello from before, it's got a language, we construct it and get the language and we have a greet, right? And so now what we're going to do is make a new class, so that class is there the way it was all along, so just assume that code's there. And now what we say is class social, new class, extends hello. So what that basically does is that pulls in all of hello, the language, the attribute language, the constructor, and the greet method is all pulled in. You don't have to repeat that at all. And we're going to add one function, a function called by. And so this is the logic for the function by. And so now we can create a new social, passing in ES, which is really calling this constructor that's been inherited from the hello. And then we've got a hi variable, hi, and it's got a greet method, but this greet method has really been inherited from the hello. And then we have a by method, and that is the part that we've added in the social class. And so that's how that works, is that it really is pull all this stuff in, fill up that class with all the stuff that's in the hello class. You could still make a hello object or a social object. Hello didn't stop existing because we added it. We just copied it and then extended it. So inheritance is the ability to take a class and make it and extend it to make a brand new class without harming the first class in the first place. Now I want to talk a little bit, now that we've talked about classes and inheritance, about the more sophisticated bit of visibility. I've told you about two levels of protection. One is public, which means that the variable can be accessed inside the class and outside the class. Private means it can only be accessed inside the class. That's the new one we haven't shown before. Protected means it can be accessed in the class, not outside the class, but in any derived class, in any child class, in any subclass. So that's protected. And so I used protected earlier, but private is the most protective thing. Protected means I'm sharing this data with subclasses and not the outside world. So let's just take a look at some sample code. With protected and private. So here's a class. We got a public variable. We got a protected variable and a private variable named pub, pro, and priv, respectively. And so in this code, inside of a method that's inside the class, you can look at and touch the protected. You can look touch the public, the protected, and the private. In the main code, this is the outside. So again, this is the inside. Inside the class, this is outside. And part of this is so the class can sort of build a protective barrier around itself and say, look, I'm going to let this little bit here sneak out so you can see it, but I am not going to let you see these things. You cannot see them. I'm hiding them from you. Okay? And that's mostly because it doesn't want this outside code that might not understand what it means to change that variable to be changing the variable. So just please don't change the variable. Well, you're not allowed to change the variable. So a public variable can be read, it can be modified outside of the code. But a protected and a private will blow up. It'll just fail, right? And and print hello is a public function. You can actually make private functions and protected functions as well. Methods. Okay, so now assume all that. We've got my class with public, protected, and private. And now we're going to make a subclass, an extension. So we're going to extend it by extending my class, importing all of the attributes and methods into my class. And we now have print hello. This print hello is not the same as print hello here. We've actually overridden it. And so now we have imported everything from this class except print hello we're going to define differently in the subclass. And so within print hello, we can look at the public stuff, we can look at the protected stuff, but we cannot see the stuff that is private in my class, right? We can look into the protected stuff of my class and modify it and touch it and look at it, but we can't look at the private stuff. And so private means I am putting such a wall around this data that even if you make a derived class, you still can't see this variable. And don't worry so much about why, just understand that there is this notion of wrapping data and having different levels of protection for that data. If when we make a new class here, we can still access the public data. That public data was originally from my class, not my class 2, but that works. But of course, the private and protected cannot be seen here in the outside world. Okay, so that's how that works. Don't worry too much about it. I really am more interested in you understanding the concepts. And the last bit I want to talk about is something that I don't recommend. You know, these days we mostly make classes exactly the way I just showed you, but a lot of older code would actually construct objects from scratch without having a class. So this is kind of a class. This is an object without a class, okay? And some people prefer this over just putting a bunch of keys, string keys, in an array because it's a little cleaner. It seems a little tighter than just strings. And so here we go. And there's this thing called Stdclass, standard class. And so what it does is standard class is like a class that is empty. It has no constructors, it has no attributes, it has no methods. Okay. So you make it and you have a class. And so what happens now is there is a object called player out here. Right, there's a player object, and we start putting stuff into it. We start changing attributes, right? So we can make a name attribute and stick Chuck in there, and we can put a score attribute and make it be 0. We can add one to the score attribute. And so what's happening is there was nothing defined here. It's like an empty class, and we're defining it as we write our code. We're just creating variables inside of it. And so that's one of the things is you can take and put variables inside, attributes inside classes if you really want, right? And so there we go. So that's a class. If we were going to define the class, we could do something like this, class player, you know, there's a name variable and a score variable, but this is sort of inventing it from scratch. And so here in the non sort of, from scratch, you just make the class, you construct the class. The class has two variables in it, and then you can do things like access the attributes and print them out. So you can kind of achieve the exact same thing by defining a class. This is kind of old school, and so the older the code is, the kind of less it feels comfortable about classes, and it sort of treats classes as a variation on associative arrays. The more modern stuff, and increasingly you're going to see people really defining the classes and putting the attributes and the functions and the methods right in those classes and doing all that stuff. So I would totally understand if you watched all these lectures and be like, oh, object-oriented programming just scrambled my brain, because that is a completely rational answer and reaction to the first time that you see object-oriented programming. And so all I'm doing here is desensitizing you to object-oriented programming. I'm not expecting you to be a whiz. I'm not going to ask you to write objects. All I want you really to be able to do is read object-oriented documentation and construct PHP that makes use of objects. So we're going to be using PDO and other kinds of things in this class. And I want to be able to say, it's the PDO class. And then there's the, you know, connect method and the XYZ method and the attribute that's this. And it's a static attribute, so that's the colon colon operator. I want you to be able to look at code, and I want you to be able to look at documentation. And that's really what my goal was. But these concepts of templates and instances and inheritance are powerful and profound, and if you go far enough in programming, you will come back to this and you go like, oh, I'm so glad that they built that stuff. But that's not here at the beginning. So I hope this was helpful. I hope you took out of this what you need. Don't feel like you need to master this. Just kind of understand the terminology, okay? See you on the net.